During Bach's nearly 6 years at Köthen, in which he married for a second time, the composer produced two instrumental works that have taken on particular importance in studies of the composer's musical development and career. One of these, completed in 1722, is the first book of Das wohltemperierte Klavier, the well-tempered clavier. The second book was composed in Leipzig between 1738 and 1742. With the subtitle Preludes and Fugues Through All the Tones and Semitones, the well-tempered clavier has been described as a triumph of music technology, a work designed to celebrate the newly devised tonal system called equal temperament, in which the octave, the musical distance between two pitches of the same letter name, is divided into 12 equal semitones. Comprising a prelude and a fugue, an archaic imitative genre, in all keys possible, the well-tempered clavier flaunts exactly that. An instrument tuned according to the latest specification, allowing for the composition and performance of music in the full range of keys. Yet the work also served a second purpose, one that by now we might expect of Bach's music. As the title page indicated, the well-tempered clavier was designed for the use and profit of the musical youth desirous of learning, as well as for the pastime of those already skilled in this study. Learning, as was typical with Bach, comprised both practice and theory, performance and composition, and the well-tempered clavier provided instruction in both. The work taught students how to read and play in all the keys one could imagine, and it offered compositional models in music of contrasting styles, from free-form and improvisatory preludes to strictly imitative fugues. The B minor fugue, the very last piece in the cycle, would probably have been particularly useful for students. The opening theme, which recurs in different keys and rhythms throughout, is marked by wide leaps between high and low notes, chromatic passes between adjacent notes, and adventurous harmonies.